Hi, it's Hope and welcome to the video. This is going to be my April mid-month wrap-up, and hopefully this will be a really quick video because so far in April I have only finished 4 books. And then I'm like 50% into 2 other ones, but they won't be included in this because I'm not finished them. So let's just get started with these books. And the first book I read was Aurora Rising by Amie Kauffman and J. Kristoff. I was originally supposed to read this in March, but it was a carryover from March into April, so it was the first book I read. And I gave Aurora Rising 4 stars. So I'm just gonna read the description of the book out because I have tried to film this portion like 4 times already and have failed to properly describe this book properly. So the year is 2380 and the graduating class of Aurora Academy are being assigned their first mission. Star pupil Tyler Jones is ready to recruit the squad of his dreams, but his own bonehead heroism sees him stuck with the dregs. Nobody else the Academy would touch. A cocky diplomat with a black belt in sarcasm, a sociopath scientist with a fondness for shooting her bunkmates, a smartass tech whiz with the galaxy's biggest chip on his shoulder, an alien warrior with anger management issues, a tomboy pilot who's totally not into him, in case you were wondering, and Ty's squad isn't even his biggest problem. That would be Aurora O'Malley, the girl he rescued from interdimensional space. Trapped in cryosleep for 2 centuries, Ori is a girl out of time and out of her depth. But she could be the cataclysm that starts a war millions of years in the making, and Tyler's squad of losers, discipline cases, and misfits must just be the last hope for the entire galaxy. Yeah, I tried to explain that like again 4 times and I couldn't because I kept on missing details and like saying things that were spoilers. But essentially we follow Tyler and his crew as they're sent on the mission, and that mission goes sideways, and that's kind of again all I can describe. I love these characters so much. Like, I would say I like the characters more than the plot. My favorite characters I would have to say are Tyler, Ori, and Finian. I loved them so much. But I loved all of these characters. The universe is so cool because we're in the Milky Way galaxy, but there's not only humans, but there's also, well, humans which are called something else. I can't not remember what the humans are now called. We have like multiple alien species interacting with humans, and we just have so much like coolness going on. And just, I'm usually not one for sci-fis. If you like have watched multiple videos, you know that I don't read that many sci-fis. Like, this year I think I've read maybe, like this year I've read maybe, I think 6 sci-fis, so like not that many. I don't read that many. I think I've only read maybe like 10 to 12 give or take sci-fis in my entire like lifetime, so this is definitely my favorite that I've read, I think. I enjoy these characters. I enjoy the mystery elements in this. I enjoyed the ending, even with how sad the ending was. And I am excited to continue this. I probably will be reading Aurora Burning within the next few months and will probably be picking up Aurora's End when it's released in November. Next we have King of Scars by Leigh Bardugo, and I can't explain anything in this book because it's the first book in the King of Scars duology, but it's the 6th book in the overall Grishaverse, and if I described this book I would spoil both the Shadow and Bone trilogy and the Six of Crows duology, so I'm not going to say anything about this. But this was a reread for me. I read this. This was the last book that I read in 2019, and I picked it up again for the release of, I picked this up again because Rule of Wolves came out the end of March. That's actually the book I'm currently reading, and I wanted to do a reread of this before Rule of Wolves. Excuse me, phone. But I wanted to do a reread of this and so I could read Rule of Wolves, and then also so I could be caught up on all the books before the Shadow and Bone TV show comes out, which comes out in 8 days as I'm filming this. I think 6 days as I'm uploading this. So yes, such a short amount of time. And I gave this a 4.5. I think I enjoyed it more upon reread because my original rating was a 4-star, and I'm like, this I think is a 4.5 because I love these characters. I would have to say that, like, the Grishaverse world is one of my favorites because just of how unique it is. But yeah, I enjoyed this so much and I don't really have anything else to say. Next, I read Fragile Remedy by Maria Ingrande Mora, and I gave it a 4 stars. Fragile Remedy, we follow Nate, who is a gem, and a gem stands for a genetically engineered metatissues, which were created for kind of medical use and all of that. But when, and typically gems live in like research facilities and all of that, but Nate, when he was young, he was taken by his mom, who is like, I think like a scientist type thing, and was moved to a different area, and he's been kind of fending for himself with the help of people and all of that, if that makes any sense. I'm struggling to describe this book. But gems weren't meant to survive beyond a, like, teenhood. Like, they weren't meant to survive into their teens without being in the medical facility. So Nate must have this thing called Remedy to survive. And essentially it's almost like a drug that keeps him alive. And when this drug runs out, he must kind of figure out what to do. That is a awful description of this. I definitely would recommend checking out the Goodreads description because I'm sucking at that description, but that is kind of the bare minimum. I will say that this does have trigger warnings for like drug abuse and like drug addiction, because that is a very heavy topic that is discussed through this book that I was expecting, but not to the extent that it was. And this is a dystopian sci-fi with a hint of queer romance, and I'm trying to figure out what else I can say without spoiling it. But I just really enjoyed this book. Again, 4 stars. This is a book I've been meaning to read for a while, even though it was just released last month. I've had an arc for months, and I'm mad that I didn't read it sooner because I really enjoyed it. I will say that it's not the, like, best world with the best characters, but I did really enjoy the characters, and it is very, like, ambiguous with, like, how gems were created, because it's not said at all of why the city the way it is, and all of that is very, like, not detailed, which I liked because you're more focused on the characters in the world. So that is one thing that I did like. And it's a standalone, so, like, a standalone dystopian. A standalone queer dystopian. What else? Like, what doesn't sound good? And the final book that I read in this, like, first half of the month was Containment by Caryn Lix, and this is the sequel to Sanctuary, which I read in March. So I can't explain Containment because, well, spoilers, but I can explain Sanctuary. So Sanctuary, we follow 17-year-old Kenzie, who is the junior guard on Sanctuary. And Sanctuary is a prison in space for anomalies, and anomalies are essentially children with superpowers. And these children are dangerous, that is why they are put in prison. But when things start to go wrong on Sanctuary, and Kenzie gets kidnapped by the prisoners, it is revealed that there is something on Sanctuary that should not be. That is kind of all I can explain. It's a sci-fi horror, and like with superpowers, and that's all I can explain. And Containment, we follow the end of Sanctuary, and I guess I'll say we're at a new location, almost redoing events from Sanctuary. I gave this a 3.5 because a lot of the elements in Containment were the exact same as Sanctuary. I can't say why. I will say that the enemy is badder. Not the enemy is like a bigger, badder version of the first books, but also our characters leveled up. We'll say that. I'm trying to figure out what I can say without spoiling it. I do like these characters. There was a huge plot twist that I was like, I'm sorry. What? No, there was two. Yeah, there was two. I just remembered another plot twist. Yeah. So there was like two plot twists that I was kind of like, oh, well, that's okay. But again, it reused a lot of elements from Sanctuary that were elements that I liked. Like, don't get me wrong. I did like this. I just liked Sanctuary a bit better. And I really hope that I like the final book, Salvation. I think that's the final book. A lot more, because this is almost based on Sanctuary and Containment. I would say that you almost could read Sanctuary as a standalone. And that, I don't like that I can say that and mean it, because Containment was good, but it was almost just Sanctuary 2.0. But I hope you enjoyed this video, and I hope I didn't blab on too long. I also really hope that I'm able to complete my TBR, because there is like, I think I still have like over like 10 books still on my TBR. Let's count. Yeah, because I have, I think if I did my math, I have 12 more books that I need to read. Well, one I just need to read the first two sections of, but like 10, like 12 books in 15 days. Also when like three of them are over 600 pages. One was, I think, over 500 pages. One of which I don't even know if it's going to arrive in April. Another of which is a format I'm not used to. And then also the Shadow and Bone TV show coming out in a week. So let's hope I'm able to get this TBR done, or May's going to have a really long TBR with a lot of punishments. But I hope you enjoyed this video. Let me know what books you have read so far this month. Have you done better than me? Have you done worse than me? Really, as long as you're reading, you can't do any worse than me, really. If you read one book a month, you're a reader. If you read 20 books a month, you're a reader. If you read one book a year, you're still a reader. I hate when a lot of people are like, oh my god, you read blank amount of books. I only read blank. You're such a better reader. And I'm like, no, I just read books pretty fast. I've also had a bunch of things going on in my personal life that has caused me to not be able to read a lot, even though I'm not working. It's like, of course, when I have time off from work and I actually have time to read, everything else gets piled on my plate, but like, that's life, I guess. But I hope you enjoyed this video, and again, sorry for any rambling, but bye!